नमस्कार चिल्ड्रन, एज यू नो दैट चैप्टर नंबर 3 इज गोइंग ऑन, दैट इज बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट एंड द फीचर्स ऑफ न्यू इंडस्ट्रियल पॉलिसी व्हिच वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन द मंथ ऑफ जुलाई 1991 वी हैव डन एंड दीज थ्री ऑफ द टर्म्स लिबरलाइजेशन, प्राइवेटाइजेशन एंड ग्लोबलाइजेशन इज स्टिल गोइंग ऑन, दैट इज द एलपीजी मूवमेंट. So the policy of liberalization, privatization and globalization made a significant change in the working of Indian firms. And today we are going to discuss about those significant changes. So the first point is, in this context, increasing competition. Due to the entry of multinational companies, competition for Indian firms has increased. Means this competition was just like the threat from MNCs. As a result of changes in the rules of industrial licensing and entry of foreign firms, competition for Indian firms has increased, especially in service industries like telecommunications, airlines, banking, insurance, etc., which were earlier in the hands of the public sector. The second impact is the more demanding customers. Increased competition create customers more demanding. Customers today have become more demanding because they are well informed. Increased competition in the market gives the customers wider choice in purchasing better quality of goods and services. The third impact is the market orientation. Today, customer is the king. Earlier, firms had production oriented, like produced first and then go to the market. But now, firms have to study and analyze the market first to identify customer needs and produce goods accordingly, like market oriented. In other words, we can say that they had production oriented marketing operations. In a fast changing world, there is a shift to market orientation in as much as the firms have to study and analyze the market first and produce goods accordingly. So this is the third impact which was there due to the government policy change on business and industry. Now move on to the next point, that is rapidly changing technological environment. After globalization, the world-class competition is started, and to face this competition, the companies need to adopt world-class technology. Rapidly changing technological environment creates tough challenges before smaller firms. Increased competition forces the firms to develop new ways to survive and grow in the market. New technologies make it possible to improve machines, process, products and services. So the rapidly changing technological environment creates tough challenges before smaller firms. The next point is more employment opportunities. Even along with it, need for the developing human resources is also there. The introduction of foreign companies and growth in economy has led to job creations. And the Indian enterprises have suffered for long with inadequately trained personnel, inadequately trained human resources, the manpower. So the new market conditions require people with higher competence and greater commitment. Hence, the need for developing human resources was also very much important at the same time.